we are going to use Capacitor to access native functionality from our Ionic applications. To demo this, I have a simple Ionic application that has one page, and that page has a button called Take Picture. If we see the HTML, we see that the button calls the Take Picture function, and that function doesn't do anything right now, it just logs to the console. And we can test it by clicking the button, and we can see the message in the console. The first thing we want to do is integrate Capacitor. And for that, we are going to write Ionic integrations, enable Capacitor. It's going to start installing all of the packages that we need. Once it's done, we can open our File Explorer, and we can see that it generated a new file called capacitor.config.ts. In here, it's where we have the information that Capacitor needs about our application. So make sure that webdir points to the directory where your public build is being generated. These are the web assets that you're going to deploy. In my case, that's the www folder. Next, make sure you change the app ID to something that matches your brand. It's important to review the web directory and to make sure to change the app ID to avoid having issues in the future. Before doing anything else, it's a good idea to create a build of our application, since this creates the web assets directory that Capacitor copies into the native projects. Now we can start by adding the platforms. For that, we are going to run Ionic Capacitor add. And when you click enter, it's going to ask you what platform you want to add. In my case, I'm going to select right now Android. It will go to the process of installing everything that you need. Once it's done, you can see that it created a new folder called Android, and this has everything that your application needs to natively run on Android. You can also directly pass the name of the platform you're going to add, like for example, Ionic Capacitor add iOS, and that way you skip the prompt asking for the platform and just install the one you want to install. To test that everything is working, we're going to test this with the command Ionic Capacitor run Android. It will ask what device we want to use. This depends on the emulators you have installed or if you have the device connected to your computer. And when we click the device, you can see that it opened the emulator and it opened our application again. Now we want this to actually do something, so we are going to add some functionality to the application. The idea is that when the user clicks this button, it will actually open the camera, let you take a picture, and then, as you can see in the HTML, it's just going to show that picture below the button. For that, we need to install the Capacitor package for the camera. And you can do that by opening the terminal and typing Ionic install Capacitor camera. Then we are going to go back into our class and we are going to import two functions from the camera package here. And they are called camera and camera result type. And then we are going to start modifying our take picture function. First, we are going to make this an async function, since the camera is going to return a promise with the picture. Then we are going to create an instance of the image. And we are going to use the camera.getPhoto method. This method takes several options that you can see all in the documentation. I will leave the link below. But the most important ones are the quality of the image that we are going to take. And let's say we are going to have full quality. Allow editing. And this tells us if you want to let the user modify the picture after taking it. So let's say false. And the most important one is the result type. Because this one is going to tell us what the camera is going to return. You have three options here, base64, data URL, and URI. I'm going to go with data URL. And then what I'm going to do is that I'm going to say that this picture right here is going to equal to whatever the result is from image.dataURL. To test this, we are going to run Capacitor again. Ionic Capacitor run Android. We select the device. And now when the application opens, you see that we can do take picture. And now the button has actual functionality. When you say, I'm going to take a picture, it's going to open since we are in the emulator. This is like the, the fake camera they have so that you can fake taking pictures. You select the picture. And now you can see that we have the picture available in our application. Now we're going to close this here. And if we want to run the same thing on the web, you see that I'm just going to run my Angular application. And when I try to take the picture, it's going to say, unable to load PW elements. So this will only work when the application is running natively through Capacitor. But we can get it to also work on the web. For that, the Ionic team created another package that's called Ionic PWA Elements. You can open the terminal and type npm install Ionic PWA Elements. And once that's done, we're going to go to the main TS file. And this is where we bootstrap the app module. And we are going to import the package here for define custom elements. And after the platform is done, we are going to say define custom elements. And we are going to pass here the window. Now we can save and rerun our application. And as you can see, when I click take picture now, it's going to ask me if I want to let it use the camera. I'm going to click allow. And now there you have it. We can see the picture here on the web too.